Okay, welcome to, I don't know, Midnight Gaming, whatever. It's not really a show, it's more so just a category. Sometimes we might be vlogging. Sometimes I might just be shooting the shit and playing a video game. And right now, I'm playing Beavis and Butthead on the Sega Genesis. Now, hang on, I gotta see them fart first. Believe it or not, this is actually one of my favorite games. That's not me saying that this game is objectively good, really. I mean, kinda, in its own way, certainly. There's a lot of things I respect about the game. But knowing how to play it, and knowing how to beat it, although you will have to maybe, there we go. You may have to be a little patient with me. It's been a little while since I've played it, so it'll slowly but surely kinda come back to me. This is a game that I would play to, just kind of chill and, believe it or not, relax. Because I know how to go through it from beginning to end, and it is kind of like just playing through an episode of the TV series. First things first, now the plot of the game is that Beavis and Butthead are really excited that they have to, or that they get to go to a Gwar concert. And they go and they pick up their Gwar tickets. And oh no, Mr. Anderson's dog Colette has eaten the tickets, and it then got chewed up by the riding mower, by Mr. Anderson's riding mower. And they somehow got not only spread all the way through downtown, but it's inside of trees, it's inside of people's stomachs, and in this case, it's with old Bill on the treadmill over there, and I gotta get on the go-kart. Now, the thing about this game is that there is nothing self-explanatory about it. It's not the kind of game that you can just put in and, hey, you got the hang of it. You know what to do, you know where to go, you know where everything is. This isn't that kind of game, and you would think that it would be, given, hey, it's a Beavis and Butthead game. They're going around and they're collecting tickets so they can see a Gwar concert. Now, the game that you picture in your head is probably like, you know, like, okay, take this for instance, the hospital. You go from the beginning of the end to the hospital, maybe you gotta defeat some villains, you fart on the police, and all that, and at the end there'll be a ticket waiting for you. But no, it's intricate as fuck. For some reason they decided, like, hey, you know what, we'll take Beavis and Butthead and we'll make like a LucasArts adventure game out of it. Like, oh, what if it were a little more in common with Simon's Quest? And I remember when this game first came out, and we were all excited about it, because, you know, it's Beavis and Butthead. It'll be great, you know, we get to play as Beavis and Butthead. And the game, it looks like the cartoon. It does. It looks like the graphics are great, the sound's great, the music is fantastic. And our video store had, like, two copies of it, or at least one of the video store that we always went to. There's several video stores in Springfield, but the one that was always on the way home only had like two copies of it on Sega Genesis, because I had the Sega Genesis and Dave had the Super Nintendo. So we grew up playing both. It's just that, you know, we would exchange it and go to each other's houses and things like that. I gotta figure out which one I want to do next. I believe Burger World. I'll be going back to Burger World later. But I want to go here early on because I want to get the pea shooter. First, I gotta kill Todd. And so anyway, after what seemed like weeks and weeks of, let me get the Rhiney the Rat and the pea shooter. What seemed like weeks and weeks of the game always being checked out, finally there was a copy of it. There was a copy of it there at the video store. Oddly enough, this is one of the parts that I actually did figure out on my own, the code. When I first played the game, I actually did, because I saw there were, I didn't realize going into when I first played it, I didn't realize the game would be as intricate as it is. I thought it would be a little more self-explanatory, and I'm sure Burger World was one of the first levels I played on the game. So when you get to this keypad and the number pad and everything, I was like, oh, it ate, and it's got to be something easy, so it's probably Butthead. Not knowing, of course, that, oh, well, clearly I need to put the fries and the dead rat inside the fryer in order to get Stuart's dad to vomit it up, and obviously I need the headphones so I can take to the pawn shop later. Okay. Where is... Oh, gotta put the fries in there, too. Alright, where's the rat? There we go. Alright. Anyway, so I actually rented this game quite a bit, and the first handful of times I played it, on the weekends that I had it, I gotta give him, that's more like it, boys. Each level kind of has a little something to do with an episode of the show, like in this case, except on the show it was Mr. Anderson who ate the dead rat.
Large pie, fried, large coffee, pronto.
So I guess maybe you could kind of figure it out on your own if you're like, oh yeah, I remember the episode where they put flies and bugs and a rat in Mr. Anderson's food. Obviously, that must be what I have to do. But when I was playing it, those first handful of times, I could tell that it would be something that I would like if I knew what to do. Like, because I was kind of having fun going through it and just killing Todd, Earl, and the security guys at the mall and things like that. And you can get, like, this big, like, boxing glove on a stick thing and fucking beat shit and tear apart shopping carts, and you get the nail gun later, and you could be like fucking Rambo. So I kind of had a feeling that, like, okay, if I really kind of knew where to go and what to do, I would probably enjoy this better as a whole. And luckily, they actually released a cheater's guide for this, and I just randomly found it one day when my mom and I were at Walden Books. This is not long after the game came out. And yeah, it was in Walden Books, and I saw that. I'm like, oh, success, a strategy guide, or cheater's guide, rather. It's kind of it's a little bit of both, because while the cheater's guide on it will certainly, it'll tell you where the tickets are. It does do that. Because honestly, there's really going to be no other way you're going to find it out. Excellent, I got two. Okay, let me think of where to go next. The street. Now, what the strategy guide or the cheater's guide won't tell you is that it doesn't give you a good strategy. It kind of tells you where, it tells you what you need and where things are, but it doesn't give you an order in which to do it. You kind of got to figure that strategy out on your own. Because there's certain parts that are easier to kind of go back to a couple of times. While the cheater's guide, it may say something like, oh, you should do the street first, or oh, you should do the high school first. For me, it was always easier to get the hospital out of the way first, because that has fuck. Because that has, in my opinion, not that it's the hardest part, but it's the part that'll fuck you up the most. Because this is a game in which you only have one life. And if you get fucked up on the racing part with the go-kart, that's it. Like, so, you know, you could get, like, I'm kind of trying to build my health back up. You could get all of these tickets, and then that, just one wrong turn, just one wrong move, just a couple of wrong moves on the go-kart, and you'll have to just start all over. But the thing about the game is that it's really generous with health. Like, see, there's a hot dog right there, and I'm gonna come back for that later, because you have to go all the way through this, and back. It's generous with health. Like Earl up there was regenerated right away just after going off the screen, and that does help to just regenerate. And you can also switch back and forth between Beavis and Butthead. So if Butthead were to get really, really low. I could just switch right over to Beavis. And you will get hurt in this part. You'll get more hurt here than honestly you do in the hospital. It's just easier to kind of fuck up in the hospital. Damn it, I'm really getting hurt bad. You got to, in order to get across this, you got to do the super jump, which is A, you hold A and then B, because A will make you run and just run and jump. But when it's a long one like this, where there's the three drips, you're going to get hit. The third one's going to get you. But you can at least, fucking rats, you can at least get past the two drop parts fine. Okay, there's a lot of dead people down here. How many people have lost their goddamn tickets? Okay, and I'm definitely gonna need, okay. I'll grab some health there, and I need that duck for later. I'll try to explain as much as I can. Hopefully I'm giving you a better script. I got the nail gun. The nail gun's the best weapon in the game. Big mallet is really good too, but that eats, you have to buy that, and that eats up a lot of your money, and you need your money. You need your money to get into the drive-in. You need your money for a few things. Alright. Gotta get that floating burrito. So yeah, you don't need the boot. The boot is something you could do couch fishing on later, but you don't want that. It'll bring an enemy. I think it brings Earl. Again, a thing you just gotta kind of learn the hard way. Fucking Todd. And the one thing they never did on the show that I can remember anyway is straight up murder Todd. I was a big Beavis and Butthead guy. Still am. I can still watch Beavis and Butthead and laugh my ass off. And see, my health is already regenerated. It, like I said, for a game in which you only have one life, and if you know what to do, and you're, if you know what to do, at least, I mean, it's generous. It's generous with life. Or, I'm sorry, but it's not being generous right now. Fuck. That's the thing, like, the villains can really fuck you up in the sense if you get too close, it can be kind of hard to get in front of them to shoot them back away from you. I had that problem with Earl earlier. But again, I was kind of fucking up a little bit right there, but I didn't get hurt enough to where it really mattered, because I got a burrito or hot dog or whatever from Todd. And I need the bone. Now I'm just playing it. But I was a big Beavis and Butthead guy. In high school, there were Daria people and there were Beavis and Butthead people. I was definitely a Beavis and Butthead guy. But I watched Beavis and Butthead first run. I was allowed to watch it. My mom was also a huge Beavis and Butthead fan. I remember being at like the taverns and the bars with my mom after their softball games. Beavis and Butthead would be on TV. I'd be the sober one there because I was like, I don't know, 10 or 12, whatever. Okay, now I can get that burrito. A little bit drained, and I got a little bit of health missing. But I can, unless I really, really fuck up, I can get through this. So anyway, I Beavis and Butthead is still a show that I go back to. It's endlessly clever. It's so funny, and I take a lot of happiness in the sense that I've gotten a lot of people turned on to Beavis and Butthead, people who didn't grow up on it, because at first glance, they might think like, oh, it's just about a couple of guys laughing at things. And it is, there is a lot of that in there, but it's genuinely funny. They do really smart. Wow, that is one of the only times I've made it across the three drip part without getting hurt. I might just time that just right. One of the first times I've been able to do that in like 20 years, and of course a fucking rat just got me, but whatever, I'll ride that. I did it again! Man, I guess that's I should have just been talking the whole time when playing it before. Now this is, I'll get the hot dog. This is a two-player game, but, and this is coming from somebody who's pretty good at this game, as I get hit by this fucking guy. This is coming from someone who is really good at this game. If you're playing this game two-player, you're not gonna make it. Like, you can be great at this game, you can be absolutely fantastic, but if you're playing with somebody who's not good at it and doesn't know how to play it and doesn't know how to time everything, okay, I need the bone, and I gotta do it. This is another thing that can fuck you up easily. You've gotta throw that bone to Collette. You just gotta inch your way to her. Or else if you don't have that bone and you don't throw it away from Collette, she'll come off the leash and she'll attack you and you cannot, okay, I need Mr. Anderson's key. And you cannot get her off. She will kill you. She will drain your life all the way down and you will be dead. And there is a password system in case you do die, but whatever. Alright, it honestly would take you just as long to play through the game again as it would to enter in their long ass password. Alright, need the chainsaw. You gotta go in, you gotta get Mr. Anderson's key, you gotta get the bone to throw to Collette. This is kind of harkening back to, I think it was the Lawn and Garden episode, the one where they were supposed to prune Mr. Anderson's tree, and instead it landed on the house. We pruned the house, too. And sure enough, look, there's a key underneath the tree trunk, or in the tree trunk, because why wouldn't there be? That's how things work. If you have someone playing this game with you, and they're not good at it, the person's gonna die fast, and when one person dies, you both die. But honestly, even if you do have two people, I always play as Butthead. Even though Beavis is my favorite, I play as Butthead, because Butthead's like, he's the Mo Howard, right? Like, he's the leader. He's the leader of the two. I need the remote. There we go. If you do have two people that are really good at this game, you'll have a better chance, but it's like playing Battletoads, you know? Like, if you're doing it two-player, you're gonna get fucked up pretty easily. And again, when you're playing it as one person, you can, if your health starts getting really, really low, you can go ahead and switch over to, you can switch over to Beavis, so you can switch over to Butthead, in order to help let the other person regenerate. I'm gonna do the Highland High School now. It's kind of a hard level. Yeah, I'm gonna throw a fishing pole at him. You only need the fishing pole for one part. I usually do that last, before the couch fishing part, before going to the Guar concert. Yeah. Anyway, if you have two people playing this game, whoa, he regenerated fast. If you have two people playing this game who are really good at it, you're both going to be going towards health. Your health is both going to be going down at the same time. Like, you've got to be, like, just flawless at this fucking thing. Okay, this part's kind of tricky. What you have to get both of those potions that are on Buzzcut's desk, and to do that, you can't just... I'm going to do it as Beavis. You can't just shoot the nail gun at him or shoot the pea shooter at him. You got to either fart or belch on him. And that will stun him for a little bit, and you just have to run over there and get as many as you can, and you will get hit. Yes! And usually the health, it'll... Unless you get hit a lot. Like, I took a hit right there from Earl, and another one. But you'll get your health... Your health will... When I get the burrito or the hot dog or whatever, the health will make up for pretty much double whatever hit you took. And you're always going to take a hit from, like, the skateboard or the shopping cart or just something small like that. But you'll take a hit from it, but getting hit by the skateboard or shopping cart or whatever, it doesn't take that much health off of you. Like, look at that. Like, I took a hit from Earl. I took a hit from, like, two skateboards and just one burrito. I'm up to full health again. Okay, I need the... Mr. Van Driessen will give you a clue. Like, if you boys are fishing for answers, try closer to home. It's kind of those clues where, like, it makes sense when you know what he's talking about, but I guess you could probably put it together in your head that he's talking about couch fishing right there. But some of them are just, they're just there to fuck with you. They know you can't beat this game on your own. If, you know what, I totally believe it, that there probably are some people out there that, without any kind of strategy guide or anything, or any kind of clue or walkthrough, have beaten this game and figured everything out with hours of trial and error, maybe. I don't know. Like, it would be cool to meet and talk to that person, honestly. Like, the same person who got through Simon's Quest on their own. Motherfucker. There's a couple of them that I did figure out on my own. It's not like, he's gonna come back. It's not like I needed the guide for everything. I did know how to do the Burger World one. I don't know, I was commenting about that earlier. But that one, I think I figured it out on accident, honestly. I think, like, I accidentally dropped the rat in the thing, and through, like, a lot of just button pushing and trial and error, I remember, yeah, getting that ticket before I got the strategy guide on it. You could figure out the hospital one pretty easily, because really that's where you just got to get to the end of it. Okay, and now what you got to do here is go into McVicker's office, and the ticket's on his head. Goddamn, I remember this being so fucking frustrating when I first played this game, because I could see the ticket. It's right fucking there. It's right there. And I remember being a kid playing this. I would have been 13, I guess, when this game came out. 13, 14. And I remember just being like, jumping back and forth, like, motherfucker! You motherfucker. Like, trying to get that ticket. Trying to shoot, trying to beat it off of him, belch on him or anything. No, that doesn't do it. What you gotta do is, clearly, you gotta take the two things, the two potions that you stole from Buzzcut and murder him, I guess. You give it to him. Boom! He has a heart attack, I suppose. Like in the finale. like in the series finale. I'm pretty sure McVicker's dead by the end of that. And now you gotta go back to the... You gotta go all the way back to the beginning. It can't just end right there. No, no. There can't just be a little TV screen to get you out of there. You gotta go to the beginning of it. And this girl will punch you. Yeah, she did. She got me right there. Hey, baby. Check out our beards. Damn, we're smooth. I got beards on my hands. Look how mature we are. Whoa, you look old. If you can't tell, my favorite episode is the beards one, when they fucking glue their own hair to their face. I love that episode. Whenever I introduce Beavis and Butthead to somebody, that's usually the one that I start with. That's one of my favorites. Any Mr. Anderson one is. Like, Mr. Anderson's balls, pool toys, lawn and garden. Home Improvement, is that the one where they have to paint his house and they steal his riding mower? That's a really good one. Any of those are among my favorites. The one where they get influenced by watching the Ben Franklin documentary and go fly a kite with a key on it. Beavis, get the kite. That's one of my favorites. The one where they're watching Iron Justice, which is RoboCop, and I only got five more left. And Beavis has a near-death experience and goes to heaven with St. Peter. Peter! That one's one of my favorites. Okay, I think the next one I want to do is the mall. And the mall was probably the first one that a lot of people played, because it's the first one that pops up on the remote here. And you can go to any of them, anytime. It's... You know, you gotta figure out your own strategy, your own order for doing this, what works best for you. And I'm kind of doing the one that I'm most comfortable with. Again, there's just things that using the guide for doesn't really help you on, like giving you your own groove, your own order. Like, honestly, watch the... if you want an example of how really non-self-explanatory this game is, watch James and Mike Mondays when they did this one. And there is an Angry Video Game Nerd episode on this, and he actually liked the Super Nintendo one better. I never had really good luck playing the Super Nintendo version. I'm sure if I sat down and really kind of figured everything out, like with this, or at least had some clues or some help, that I would probably have fun with the Super Nintendo one too. But this, I just enjoyed this one a lot more because I know how to play it. There are three tickets in this one, and you have to, for this, there's a ticket over here in the bird cage. You can't tell it's there. It's not sitting there, but it's there. Again, one of those things like really, like, how was I gonna figure that out? If you look at that in the James and Mike Mondays episode, they're using the strategy guide in one part. Okay, first you have to buy the snake. You gotta let him package it for you, and when he packages it, that's when you take the key. If he's standing up there and you try grabbing the key, he's not gonna let you take it. So, okay, they can only hold so many things at a time, so I gotta switch over to Beavis to take the snake. And now I need to use the key that I stole to let the bird out. Polly want an Alka-Seltzer? alright. Let me open that up. Come on, let me open it. Open! Open, you son of a bitch. I knew you. There we go. And he's gonna shit on you, or drop eggs on you. You might get a little injured, but whatever. Anyway, you can tell that James and Mike are using the guide. They pull it out at one point, and it's the same one that I had. But again, it doesn't give you a very good order of how to do things. You still got to figure that out on your own. So when they were eating the poison burger, which I'll get to later, when they're eating the poison burger, it's killing them, and they don't know why. And you need to do that. It doesn't tell you really why you need to do that, but you do need to get that burger, just not necessarily at that point in the game. And you need the... Damn it. You need the oil. Oh, shit. So that was a good time for a break. I'm actually glad that happened. See, what happened was I forgot the damn pants and had to go back to the beginning of the level, exit out, grab the pants, and come back. I'm actually kind of glad that happened because it sets me up with a little bit of a warning. And this is one thing that definitely makes this game not perfect. If you were to mess up on something and you wanted to go back to the bedroom, or maybe you forgot something and you just instantly want to exit out of the level, you might be inclined to accidentally hit where it says sucks right there. Don't do that. Don't hit where it says sucks, because if you do, you'll lose all of the items that you have. It's kind of one of those things that's put in there just to fuck you. And believe me, that happened to me the first time I played this game. Probably the first several times I played this game, honestly, before I really knew what was what. If you mess up on something and you have to go back to the beginning, go back to the beginning of the level. Oh, I don't want to go in here. You can go in the toy store. One of the things that I have to do here in the mall is I've got to get hit by shopping carts, of course. This guy. Take this, you punks. I'm going to trash my own store myself, you assholes. Okay, be here, Beavis. You can take the pea shooter just in case. One of the things you got to do here in the mall is to go into the pawn shop. And there's three things that you can sell at the pawn shop. You can sell that bird that I got in the street, and also the headset and binoculars that you find in the drive-in. And in order to... The binoculars will kind of just give you extra money if you want to go to the toy store and maybe buy Beavis a nail gun, or if you want to buy the little punching bag on a stick. If you're just playing it one player and you just want to beat the game, you really don't have to do that. You can if you're playing two player, but by that point you'll probably die anyway. Now, the reason why, let me make sure I got everything. I got the pants, I got the pants, I got soap, and I got oil. I need those three things, and that was why I definitely had to go back and get the pants. You need those three things in order to go into the laundromat. If you don't have those three things, you won't die. It's just that the guy out front won't kill you. The guard won't kill you, but he'll let you in if you have those three things. If you don't, he'll just shoot you away. Now, there's a ticket in that last laundry machine right there. And if you just go up to it and open it, you'll die. Because that old lady right there will wake you up and won't let you leave until you are dead. So you have to take the oil that I've given Beavis and put oil on the machine. And oiling the machine means it won't make a squeaky noise and you can get your ticket. You know, if it wasn't for that, this would be pretty self-explanatory. It's like you grab a few things, you go inside, and you open the laundry machine and you got a ticket, but oh no, you gotta have the oil or else you'll die and you only have one life and she'll kill you and you'll be fucked. Alright, so I've got one. There's three tickets in here and I've got one, so I think I can just go upstairs right now. Although this is kind of funny if you try using the chainsaw. Not that. Hang on. This is an MA-13 game. Chainsaws only work on trees. So you can't chop open a grasshopper like on the show. Welcome to the jungle, baby. Okay, the reason why I had to buy the snake other than just distracting the cashier, there's a ticket right underneath there, but if I were to grab that, he will kill you. He will instantly fucking kill you. And you need to grab the snake in the package and give it to him as a present. From Major Woody and Private Parts? That's another great one when they try joining the army and they play Hot Potato, the fucking grenade. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and grab the ticket under here now. And that's, I believe that's all three of them. And you need to get the bomb on here for when you go to the drive-in. And I'm gonna go to the drive-in next. Yeah, check that out. Only two tickets, only two pieces of the tickets left. Now you gotta grab the, what looks like a condom, but is actually a camera right there. Alright, next we have the drive-in, which is another part that is kind of based on an episode. There is an episode where they take a picture of a lady having sex in a van. I gotta pay first. That's why you needed to pawn shit, so you could pay to get into the drive-in. And if you accidentally, use the money on something else before you get here, you won't be able to make that $3 back. So you get the binoculars from here and you can go back to the mall and buy some shit. You can go into the bathroom and blow up the toilet with the bomb you bought, but again, then you won't be able to get the ticket. This is all stuff that I've learned the hard way, by the way. This is all stuff that the strategy guide says that you can do, but they don't tell you that it'll kind of fuck you if you do that, if you use the item in the wrong place. Now what you need to do with the bomb is blow this guy up. Or at least you run around on it. And yeah, just let that flow for a little while. And okay, the little puddles right here will slow you down. They won't hurt you, they'll slow you down. And get used to jumping over it, because you're definitely gonna wanna do that. And you just gotta get used to the fact that the rats are gonna hurt you. Alright, and now, you can get the binoculars to sell it at the pawn shop, but if you're just playing it just to beat it, don't worry about it. Alright, so you gotta get the camera and get in good running position and take a picture, and she's gonna come out and she's gonna kill you, and you gotta run. You gotta fucking run your ass off over these puddles. Yeah, she's gonna inflict some pain on you. Just, you gotta race her to here just before she kills you. She slips on the shit. Rock on, you got yourself another ticket. And the final ticket is the easiest one to get, but it's another one that can really, really fuck you up bad. First, I'm gonna drop my tickets off. I'm low on health, as you see, but part of the strategy I have I plan on that. I plan on the fact that I'm gonna need some health before I go to the Guar concert. So you got the fishing rod for Mr. Anderson's. You need the gum, and you need not do that. Damn it! Oops. Okay. Well, you can't really back out of there except going into the ball and just backing back out. Okay. So you can get some items from the couch. You can get a few. You don't want the donut, because if you go couch fishing with the donut, the cop will come and kill you. That brings Stuart, and that's kind of funny. You need the pizza, and that's it. Like, a boot brings Earl, and the billfold brings the army guy, and they'll kill you. So it's the easiest way to get tickets in the game, but they still make it kind of hard. Now, you'd think you could just keep hitting C like that, but no, you gotta hit it so fast that you pretty much have to tense up your arm to the point to where it's just making you tensing it so bad to the point to where it's just making, like, miniature tiny, like, force on the button. So just tense it up. Oh, man. Flex. Shit, it's not easy. Oh, okay, alright. Oh, I knew if I stopped talking that I'd be able to do it. You have to, like, just shut your whole body down except for flexing your arm at, like, the speed of light. And there we go. That's the final ticket. But that's not the end. It can be if you want, but we're gonna take a long way. Alright, let's go couch fishing again with the slice of pizza. Okay. And with the slice of pizza, we got a cat. You're gonna want that cat. Put the cat in your pocket. I guess that's what they did. They're walking around with a cat in their pocket. It's not time to go to the Guar concert yet, after I accidentally started fishing for a second. Okay, I need the remote. But what I need to do first is get health, and I also need something else from the hospital. And let's go over to Burger World. Now, to get my health boosted back up, obviously I can kill Todd a lot. I'm going to do that a little bit, because I am kind of really down on health right now. Okay, so that'll be enough to do what I need to do. Alright, you need to grab that poison burger right there. And it's gonna make you sick. It's like in the Burger World episode of the show. It's gonna make you sick, and it's very slowly draining your life. And if you don't know that that's what it's doing, you'll be very confused. You'll be wondering why you're dying all of a sudden. And alright, I'm gonna kill Todd a couple of times here, just for safety's sake, because I don't want to die this late in the game. And I'd be very embarrassed, because it'd be one of the first times I've died in this in, like, over 10 years. Where are you? There he is. In order to get rid of the sickness from the burger, you gotta go to the hospital, and you need scissors that are inside of the nurse's office. And the reason you need those scissors is you need those for the Guar concert. First, I kill these guys. Actually, my health is higher than it was before I ate the burger. That's how nice they are with health in this. Now, if you were to try going in there originally without eating the burger, she won't let you in, because you need to be sick in order to get in there. And alright, you hop up on the table. She's gonna give you some health. My health's all boosted up, but most importantly, I need these scissors. The scissors that are up on the wall over there. Alright, now I can... Again, don't hit... Oh shit, I forgot. I always forget about this. Alright, just gotta kill him for a little while. Ain't no way I'm riding that fucking scooter. My luck, I would fucking get my ass handed to me. I have to fucking start all over again. Alright. Again, it's important you go back to the beginning. Don't hit sucks. That is just there to tempt you to fuck up. And it's still not over. It can be if you want. If you want the game, the game can end as soon as you go in here. You can go in the front door right there, and that'll be the end of the game, and you're in the audience watching it. But if you want to do something extra, you can keep going off to the right. But you need that cat. The cat that you got with the pizza from couch fishing. Just keep inching over, keep hitting C, keep inching over, and Colette comes and chases after the cat. If you don't put the cat down for Colette to chase, it's like the street level. Colette will come out of nowhere. You can't put her in the laundry machine. You can't puke on her.
She smells worse than when I gave her to you.
we use a new detergent, lemon scented chunks.
You gotta use a little elbow grease.
We use stomach grease. There are a lot of different codes you can use for this game. Not just simply picking up where you left off. Even then, it doesn't really return you with a lot of your items. But there's little secrets here and there. You can make the boys laugh in like the opening frame. Okay, one thing I need to do here is get some health, that's for sure. There are so many of these fucking guys. Okay. There's so many of these fucking guys, you gotta be really careful. And they regenerate so fast that you kinda gotta kill, if you want health, you kinda gotta kill them when they're up here real close to you. Yeah. Alright. You can do cheat codes that'll give you all, it'll start out giving you all the items. You can do ones that'll give you 2 tickets, 3 tickets, 4 tickets, whatever, and all of that. But again, the cheat codes in this are so long that you might as well just play it back through the game. That is if you know how to play it. If not, if you still don't know how to play it, you can start out with all the items, but you won't know what to do with any of it. You could maybe get some tickets, but you probably won't realize that you needed, like, certain shit to get certain places. Okay, it's just all these guys look the same. Look, we got one bouncer. We're gonna fucking duplicate him, alright? Guar in their cloning machine. This isn't the kind of music that I grew up listening to. It's really not my kind of music, Guar. I'm a disco guy. I'm 80s retro, disco, golden oldies, 70s soft rock. Not a heavy metal dude or anything like that. So honestly, like, when this game came out, it was the first time I'd ever heard of Guar. I knew they were a real band when the game came out. I didn't think it was something that the game made up. I had friends in school when the game came out, and that they had mentioned that it's a real band. If they play sweet Sega Genesis music, then I might like them. Okay, now in order to kill this guy up here, that's why you need the scissors. You need the scissors to cut that rope that'll kill the final bouncer. There. Boom! Dead. And you also need to pick up, you can't really tell what it is, but it's a little like thong piece. You gotta pick those up, and that's it. You're now part of the show. You're part of Guar. This'll just keep going and going. You can make them fall over too. You hit, let's see, I'm on Beavis right now, so if you keep hitting B, you can just do this for hours. Or if you want a Butthead, you hit C and that'll switch over to Butthead. Just make him fall. Just go back and forth. Make him fall all over again. You know, if this happened, I'd go see a Guar concert. You can just do this for hours. I felt like doing this for hours the first time I beat this game. And that's Beavis and Butthead. To end this, you just hit start. And Mr. Van Driessen singing to animals. Come with me, lesbian seagull. Touch a mountain, climb a mountain. I love this game. It's a game that I still do play from time to time. If I just want to kind of chill and just play through a game that I've played through many times, this is one of my go-to games. It honestly is. Now, what I said at the beginning of it, it's not a perfect game. Like, there's a lot of stuff in there that's just designed to fuck you. This is a big fuck you to anyone who's just going into a game blind, because it will just completely and utterly destroy you and fuck you up. There's no reason this game needs to be as complicated as it is. There's no reason a Beavis and Butthead game needs to be this complex. Other than they're kind of dickheads when they made the game. They're like, fuck it, everyone's gonna go into this game thinking it's gonna be easy shit. Nah, fuck that, we're gonna make it like a fucking adventure game. We're gonna make it hard. we're gonna make it like it's Zelda or something. We're gonna make it like Simon's Quest or like a LucasArts game. Because fuck you, that's why. There's no reason for that, but if you know what to do, if you know where everything is, it's an enjoyable game. It is like playing through an episode of the show. The problem is, it's like an episode of the show that you need to enjoy if you're one of the writers of it. So I like it. I do. It does take me back to that particular time and wanting to really enjoy a game to the point to where you'll go out and buy a strategy guide just because you know you will enjoy it if you just fucking knew what to do. That's kind of this game. So I like the fact that I'm pretty good at this game. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed me rambling about Beavis and Butthead on the Sega Genesis. See ya. Ow.